Hello everyone and welcome to the Clone Drone in the Danger Zone tutorials, where I'm going to show you how to use the stealth and patrols mechanic. Now this appeared with the adventure level update, where you can now create enemies that respond to seeing the player and hearing the player as well. If you're looking for an example of this, then check out the zombie co-op challenge, where all the zombies in those levels use the stealth AI and you can hide from them. So let's start. This sword level 1 here is using its normal AI. But if we click Use Stealth Game AI in the bottom right here, it reveals some boxes that we can use to customize this. So I'm going to go through each of these. The instant activation range is the area within which, if the bot sees the player, they will instantly move to attack mode. This is represented by the sphere that you see increasing and decreasing as I increase and decrease the number in this box here. Obviously, the robots don't have eyes in the back of their head, so if I make this really huge, or the size of the arena or something, then it doesn't mean that the robot will instantly find and start attacking the player. It just means that if they are in front, kind of in this cone of vision, which we don't accurately represent because of the sphere, but I think it's a kind of 90 degree vision in front of the robot as opposed to behind. So let's make this quite small for the moment. So we have to really walk right up to the front of this robot to make them instantly attack us. But the sight range is a sphere where if the player or something else makes a sound inside of it, or if they become visible to the robot, then they will go and investigate that place and search for the player. Kind of like if you've played Assassin's Creed or Hitman or something like that. And we will leave the patrol route name for later in this tutorial. So let me show you how this robot works. I'm going to make the sight range much smaller for this demonstration so you can see how it compares to the other robots that don't have the stealth AI. Everyone else is using the normal AI, so they will just attack as normal in the arena. But if we enter the sight range of this robot, the little eye starts to fill up, which means that it has seen us, and when the eye fills up, it will come and try to find us. And now it's searching. But we are still within the sight range of the robot, which means that the little question mark will now fill up, and when the question mark fills up, it will move into attack mode. But we can also instantly activate this attack mode by going within the instant activation range. Another example of how this works, this right here blocks the sight line of this robot to the player. Obviously, if you go around the corner, the robot will be able to see you. But if you are within the sight range but behind something that can hide you, it won't come after you. On the other hand, if you aren't visible but you do make a sound, the robot will still come looking for you because the sound was made within their sight range. So now that you know exactly how the stealth mechanics work, we can use them to make a level. Now, something that's very handy to remember is when you're in arena mode, the enemies look at the elevator. So if you don't want them to always look in the direction of where the player is starting, especially if you've got some stealth AI enemies close to the elevator, then click Allow Custom Rotation, and that will let you use this Y coordinate to rotate them, or this rotation tool here, so that they don't look at the player and instantly get activated. As we can see here, this stealth enemy I am standing right behind. I'm even standing in their instant activation range, so I can sneak up and do a killing blow on them before they even start attacking me. And if I move around to the front of them where they can see me, they will instantly activate because they could see me. But you don't always want your enemies to be standing in one place like this fella here. You can also make them move. And if we go into the adventures part of the library, we can use a patrol waypoint. We're going to use this to make the fleet captain here do a rotation around this raptor statue. So you can either drag more patrol waypoints in from the library, or you can use Control C to copy and Control V to paste another patrol waypoint straight from the level editor. But first, we need to name this route. And as you can see, none of these patrol waypoints have a root name, and once we name this, it's not going to connect to any of the others. These three are connected because technically they have the same name, which is nothing, but this one is now called Fleet Captain. So I'm going to delete these three so I don't have to write out the root name every time and use Control C to copy it and then Control V to paste. So now we've got the root around the raptor, but it's not a circle. So to make sure that we close this circle and make it go round in one direction, we click on the final patrol waypoint and tick loop back to start, and that will close the circle. So now all we need to do is in the fleet captain, type in the patrol route name, fleet captain. Now, if you select all of this, you can copy Control C and paste Control V, the patrol route name in there to make sure it is exactly the same. Because if there's any difference in any of the letters, then this fleet captain will not go around this route. So the fleet captain still has stealth AI. It can see me and it will stop and check, but it is also moving around the raptor. And we can use that to sneak up on it. It is very fast, but you can now take it out in one hit, which is very cool. Patrol waypoints can also be used in different ways. For example, what if you want this sword one to walk between these two points so they patrol back and forth? At each end, all you need to do is tick reverse direction here and here. And here we can see this robot patrolling. Thanks for watching. Let me know in the comments if there's anything else you want to see from this level editor tutorial series. But until then, happy level editing. Goodbye.